Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React ListBox component using the create react app command. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding data and selecting items. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I create the app using the create react app toolchain and use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. Now, I'll create a new application in the command prompt, using the npx create react app command, and provide the app name, myreactapp. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, navigate to the desired location and run this example, using the npm start command. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page to show the listbox component. I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and remove the styles from the app.css file. Then import the Bootstrap 5 theme styles to apply them to the listbox component. Then I install the listbox package using the command npm install syncfusion ej2 react dropdowns. To start using the listbox component, import it from the ej2 react dropdowns package and include the listbox component tag. Then add a few styles to align this component. Let me run this application. See, the listbox component is rendered. And you will notice that no records are displayed in it. Data can be bound to the listbox component using the datasource property. I have already defined a JSON object, employees, in the data.js file. I will import that data and assign it to the datasource property. When binding the data, I also need to map the JSON object fields to the text and value fields of the listbox component. Here, I include fields property and map the employee ID to the value field and name to the text field. See here, the listbox shows the JSON data. Finally, let's see how to perform selection in the listbox component. By default, I can select only one item in a listbox. To select multiple items, I include selection settings property and set its mode to multiple. See now, it is possible to select multiple items using either the shift or control key with mouse click or arrow keys. I can also select listbox items using the checkbox. To do that, I need to inject the checkbox selection module from the ej2 react dropdowns package and inject it to the services. Then enable the show checkbox property in the selection settings. Look now, I can select one or more items using the checkbox. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion React ListBox component using the create react app command. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding data and selecting items. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.